Have you ever looked at a famous work of art and thought, I could paint that. What's the big deal? Many people feel the same way when they see pieces like Number 31, an abstract expressionist painting by American artist Jackson Pollock that's worth tens of millions of dollars. But what they don't realize is there's much more to it than meets the eye. Abstract expressionism was born in New York in the 1940s. When pioneering artists like Pollock, Joan Mitchell, and Willem de Kooning started to create works of art that reduced the things they saw in reality to their most basic form, explored conceptual ideas like the power of God, and expressed what they felt inside. This new kind of art was all about emotion, individualism, spontaneity, movement, color, and shape. And while it left many people scratching their heads, others were transfixed, understanding that there was a method to the artist's apparent madness. In the 40s, 50s, and 60s, abstract expressionism infiltrated the worlds of film, fashion, advertising, and graphic design, and even caught the attention of the CIA, who understood that this complex, edgy new art form could be used as a weapon to promote American ideals during the Cold War, and began to pump millions of dollars into the New York art scene, helping to support abstract expressionist artists and enhance America's prestige as leader of the free world. By showing people that art can be used to express what they feel rather than simply what they see, abstract expressionism not only changed how we define what art is, it opened the doors for new generations of American artists to take risks, experiment, and push the boundaries of what art could be in the future. Does art have to represent reality or look real to be valued?